हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन इंडियन पॉलिटी, मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एमसीक्यू सीरीज फॉर ऑल गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम्स एंड आल्सो फॉर जनरल नॉलेज पर्पस। पॉलिटी एमसीक्यू बाय मी इमैनुअल। आई हैव डन माय बीए इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग। लेट अस गो टू द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच इज हु इज द चेयरमैन ऑफ पार्लियामेंट्री कमेटी। सो द आंसर इज होम मिनिस्टर इज द चेयरमैन ऑफ पार्लियामेंट्री कमिटीज। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वॉट इज द मिनिमम कोरम रिक्वायर्ड in the Lok Sabha to transact any business? To start any business or to transact any business in the Lok Sabha, we need 1/10 of the minimum quorum we required. Option D is the answer. Third question, who is authorized to prorogue the session of Lok Sabha? Let me explain this in detail. See, in the parliamentary sessions, we have three words which are very commonly used. One is summon, then prorogue, then adjournment. See, summoning is nothing but starting the session. To start any session, the word which is used in parliament is summon. Next is prorogue, means to end the session, and adjournment means it is like postponing the meeting or postponing the session for some fixed amount of time. See, summon and prorogue, these both the things will be done by president itself. President have the power to summon the session and to end the session. And one more thing you should know, that this adjournment is done by respective speaker or the chairman who is presiding over the session. So the answer is President have authority to summon as well as to prorogue the session of parliament. Okay, let us go to next question. That is, which of the following provisions in directive principles of state policy reflected Gandhian principles? See, Gandhiji has very vast influence in the making of Indian constitution, but especially he has some ideals and he has some visions. So those visions in his memory we kept in our constitution. That is, one of his vision was to organize village panchayat, that is decentralization of power. So village panchayat is an example of decentralization of the power in our Indian constitution. So this was in Gandhian principle. Okay, this is the reflection of Gandhian principle, that afterwards we have organized village panchayats in our constitution. Okay, next, which of the following country follows the model of presidential form of government? You people know that in our India, the government form is parliamentary form. So we follow parliamentary form of government, that our parliament consists Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and president. These three things makes our parliament. So like that, in the USA, the government form is presidential form, means US's government follows the presidential form of government. So answer D is the right answer, USA. Whenever the word comes parliamentary form of government, you should remember India follows the parliamentary form of government. Next, sixth question, which of the following is not the domain of union government? See, we have three lists in our constitution, that is union list, then state list, then concurrent list. Union list, state list and concurrent list. In union list, central government makes the laws, or union government makes the law. In state list, state government makes the law. And in concurrent list, both state government as well as central government make the laws. So the question is, which of the following is not the domain of union government, means which of the following is not in the list of union government, that is health is not in the list of union government. See, union government presides defense sector, foreign affairs and communication. These all comes under the union government, but health is a state subject, and also law and order is also state subject. Please remember this. Next, seventh question, who can file nomination papers for the election to the Lok Sabha? So the answer for this is, any citizen of India whose name appears in the electoral rolls of constituency. If you're having ID card for the election, then you are absolutely eligible for the election of Lok Sabha. And your age must be at least 25 years to participate in Lok Sabha election. Okay, on whose written recommendation the president can declare national emergency according to 42nd constitutional amendment. See, in our country, the president is a nominal head and he is not the real head. So always he is dependent on cabinet ministers to take any crucial decision, especially in the case of emergency powers. Emergency, the president consults always to the cabinet to declare emergency or to withdraw the emergency. So ninth question is, which constitutional amendment substituted Odia for Oriya? See, by using some constitutional amendment, we have changed Odia into the Oriya in our constitution. So that is done by 96th amendment. Option C is right answer. So next question is 10th question. When was Supreme Court of India is inaugurated? This is very important question. You should know that our Supreme Court is inaugurated in 1950. Option C is absolutely right answer. So that's all about this course. We have completed 10 MCQs in this. So please like my courses. If you like my courses, please subscribe the channel and also follow me to learn more about quality, history, geography, and many more things. Thank you.